In this video, we're going to look at the division algorithm applied to polynomials and also the remainder theorem. The division algorithm says if you have a number or a function divided by a divisor and you get an answer which we call the quotient plus a remainder, we can rewrite that original number, the dividend, as equal to the divisor times the quotient plus the remainder. And here I have a numerical example. Let's say we have 52 and we're dividing by a divisor of 5. We get an answer of 10 with a remainder of 2. 10 is called our quotient, 2 is our remainder. According to the division algorithm, we can rewrite 52 as the divisor times the quotient plus the remainder. In fact, that's how we check our division. We multiply back our divisor times our quotient and add back the remainder. Here, 50 plus 2 equals 52, so we know we have the right answer. This same algorithm applies to polynomials. For polynomials, if a polynomial f of x is divided by a polynomial d of x and it results in a quotient q of x with a remainder r of x, then we may rewrite f of x as d of x times q of x plus the remainder polynomial r of x. In other words, if we divide a polynomial by another polynomial, resulting in an answer, we can multiply that answer by our divisor, add the remainder, and we should get back our dividend, which would be our original polynomial. And here's an example. We're going to divide x squared minus 3x plus 3 by x minus 1, and then apply the division algorithm to rewrite f of x as a product plus a remainder. Then we'll verify that this is a correct result. So we're dividing by x minus 1, and I've set this up as synthetic division. 1 is off to the side in our coefficients 1, negative 3, and 3. Carry down the 1. 1 times 1 is 1. Add to get negative 2. 1 times negative 2 is negative 2. Add to get 1. We get an answer of x minus 2 with a remainder of 1. So our answer is q of x equals x minus 2. We divided by x minus 1, so that's our d of x. And our r of x is just 1. There's no x in it. So by the division algorithm, we can rewrite f of x as the divisor times the quotient plus the remainder, x minus 1 times x minus 2 plus 1. And we can verify this by multiplying x minus 1 times x minus 2 and adding 1 back. And when we do that, we end up getting x squared minus 3x plus 3. So it does work out. Now there's more implications to this than just being able to rewrite f of x as a product plus the remainder. We can use this result to show what's called the remainder theorem. The remainder theorem says if f of x is a polynomial function that is divided by x minus c, where c is a real value, then f of c equals r, the remainder. And here's how we get it from the division algorithm. Let's say we divide f of x by x minus c. And we get some answer, q of x, that's our quotient, and some remainder, r. By the division algorithm, we can rewrite f of x as x minus c times q of x, whatever that is, plus r. Now if we let x equal c, when we plug in c for x, we get c minus c times q of c plus r. Well, c minus c is 0. 0 times q of c, whatever that is, it's still going to be 0, and all we're left with is r. So we can evaluate f of c simply by dividing by x minus c and noting what the remainder is. And also I have a note here that if the remainder happens to be 0, that means f of c is 0 and x equals c is a 0 of the polynomial, which also means x minus c is a factor of the polynomial. So the division, along with this remainder theorem, can tell us a lot about the polynomial. And here's an example where we divide f of x equals x to the fourth plus 2x cubed minus x squared plus x minus 1 by x minus 2, and we use that result to find f of 2, and then we're going to verify that this is indeed the correct result. So we do the synthetic division here. We put 2 off to the left and then all the coefficients of our polynomial, 1, 2, negative 1, 1, and negative 1. And we do that synthetic division, carry down the 1. 1 times 2 is 2, 2 plus 2 is 4, 2 times 4 is 8, negative 1 plus 8 is 7, 2 times 7 is 14, 14 plus 1 is 15, and then 2 times 15 is 30, add it to negative 1, and we get a remainder of 29. So that means f of 2 is 29, and I have off to the right here, I've verified f of 2 by plugging 2 into the function. 2 to the 4th plus 2 times 2 cubed minus 2 squared plus 2 minus 1, and we get 16 plus 16 minus 4 plus 2 minus 1 is 29, so it does work. Also, we've shown here that 2 is not a 0 of f of x, and x minus 2 is not a factor. So the synthetic division tells us a lot.